So hey everyone, you are watching Indeed The Royal, and in today's video we are going to talk about what really are OVAs and why are they in existence till date in the anime industry. So before starting out, make sure you are subscribed to this channel and notifications are turned on. So let's get started. The anime OVA is a staple of the industry, but though the term is still in use, its original meaning may have become more relatable over the time. Well, there are many different terms and phrases in the anime fandom and culture, many of which, like shonen or shoujo, have to do with the series genre or demographic. Another incredibly common term is OVA, and you might have heard about it even though you wouldn't be able to rectify the meaning of it. But this term has become so widely used, it is often bandied without any explanation. Either an independent work in its own right or a type of spin-off animated project, an OVA is a way to create a production independent from a popular anime series while still building off the said popularity. Alternatively, it can be an experimental medium for creators to bring an original work to audience that wouldn't normally be a good fit for the televised broadcast or theatrical release. Here's a deeper look into the world of OVAs and some of the more well-known examples of them. So in the upcoming video, I will be telling you what is an OVA and what are their effects and how they help an anime to grow. So getting started, an OVA is an acronym that stands for Original Video Animation, with the first arguably being 1983's Delos. It was a show and we had an OVA for this. These productions, as their name suggests, are tailor-made for home releases and are not screened or shown in any other format prior to this. Similar to the straight-to-video market in other countries, they were originally released as DVDs, and now more recently we are having them as Blu-rays, giving way to the term OAD, which stands for Original Animation DVD, to come into today's use. Usually, but not always, longer than one episode, OVAs have a wide range of runtimes, from small bit-sized segments to even a few hours, though it's more common for them to be around 30 minutes long, like a televised episode of a show, while OVAs can sometimes be official spin-offs, sequels, or prequels to an anime series. They can also be non-canon to the show's story or entirely original works with no previous source material. Likewise, OVAs boast much higher budgets than mainstream televised anime, resulting in significantly great production values similar to that of actual movies. Not being on television network also gives various advantages to the OVAs, as the animators can showcase content that might otherwise be censored on the television or theatrical release. This usually results in OVA adaptations being closer to their manga counterparts than the network anime versions. Now, how does an OVA enhance or surpass the series they are based on? Well, many franchises got their mainstream start not with a telestream anime but with an OVA. An example of this is Tenchi Muyo, which began as an OVA before spun off into multiple TV shows. Other franchises such as Higurashi received additional OVA episodes for some of their seasons or even an OVA spin-off movie. One of the most notable series is the adaptation of Legends of the Galactic Heroes. You might have also heard about this anime. Instead of a few mere episodes, this OVA had a grand total of 110 episodes, which was further bolstered by 52 side story episodes. And there are various other animes too that got their start from an OVA. Other well-known OVA and the recent ones could be Attack on Titan No Regrets, which followed the character Levi, as well as Universal Century's Mobile Suit Gundam, the original. Likewise, there are OVAs continue to be a huge part of the anime industry. Even as it turns more and more to streaming, this has resulted in original net animations or a new term called ONA, which are essentially just OVAs repackaged for our time, for the internet era, keeping the format and spirit of the OVAs alive to this very day. So this is all for today's video, and I hope I was able to answer all the questions regarding the OVAs. And if you guys love the content, do hit the subscribe button, turn on the notifications and give this video a thumbs up, comment down your views, and see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.